The spirit of accusation is the very nature of hell in operation. Devil nature. Let me tell you something. Just because you're a born again Christian doesn't mean that nature can't use you. That nature will jump up and accuse things in a church, accuse things in a relationship. That's the biggest demon in the church. Oh yeah. Gossip, accusations, envy, jealousy. It all starts with accusations. And the devil will put a word in you to get you to look at this so that you will disregard authority. Can I tell you, when you know that the spirit of accusation has got a hold of you, when you stop being thankful, when you stop being grateful, that's a sign that the talons of the devil is inside of you. Because he's an unthankful spirit. He's an accusing spirit. And that means that the warfare has gone deep into your soul. See, some of you, you need to do some aggressive warfare to get the devil the hell out of your soul. Jesus recognized that voice in Peter. Jesus said, I must go to Jerusalem and be crucified. And Peter, who had a revelation a few verses earlier, you are the Messiah, you are the Christ. He said, no, you can't die, Jesus. And Jesus said, get behind me, Satan. So we have a satanic spirit talking through a disciple. So if it can happen to Peter, it can happen to you. And usually what tears up churches is the voice of the accuser. You get somebody that has an anointing, you give them a position, you give them a business card, give them a parking place, and then it starts. Well, I really don't like Pastor Ibb's preaching as much as I like Apostle Day's preaching. You know, I don't really like this, but I love the Lord, blah, 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 blah. Devil! That's the voice of the accuser. And can I tell you when deliverance starts? When you recognize that voice talking to you and through you. Deliverance starts when you recognize the voice of the accuser talking to you and through you. This is the warfare that every Christian must identify if they're really going to be successful. When he said there's a war in heaven, and our accuser night and day and day and night. And the Lord is saying today, I'm coming to put my foot on the voice of the accuser that's been talking to you and been talking through you. See, if you're controlled by what other people think about you more than what God thinks about you. See, I would have never become Prophet Kevin had I listened to all the other opinions. Because everybody got an opinion about how to be you. I said, everybody got an opinion about how to be you. Let me tell you the big mystery about becoming you. I never saw Kevin Lill. I had to discover who Kevin Lill was. Do you think I preached like this when I first got saved? Oh, no. But the seed was in me. Most of you in this room today, you're bound by the fear of man. Because you think more about what man is going to say than what God is going to say when you try to do the will of God. It is the accuser of the brethren. It's a war in your soul. Now, I know that we're in a politically correct time and day. But I was getting beat up by a kid at school for a couple of weeks. And I was super, super short. I was 5'2" when I graduated from high school. But then 8 weeks after I graduated from high school, I grew 11 inches. And so when I came home, I was just crying. I'm getting beat up at school. And I had these big black glasses, them old nerd glasses. I'm beating up on my dad says, come here. He said, the next time they hit you, you take this fist and hit it right on the end of their nose as hard as you can. And I said, well, he said, hit him. And this guy tried to bully me. I went, and I'm a little bit shrug. I went, the guy blinked 4 or 5 times, backed up. He never bothered me again. Some of you need to hit the devil smack in the face. Push back. Whoa, hey, culture. I get